This is a short recording to test out Camtasia with Python. This is the Thonny program that I asked you to download. I'm just going to talk briefly about this little short program. You notice the three quotation marks followed by a comment and then three quotation marks. This is often used to create a multi-line comment at the top of your program. Another comment marker in Python is the pound sign, hashtag. This is a one-line comment. Generally, you might use this just to tag a comment often on the end of a line, on the end of a piece of code to maybe give a short description. This would be the preferred choice for a comment block at the top of your program. So this line 7 that you see here is simply an example of using the input function in Python. The input function allows you to pass it a string of text to display when the program is run. And the input function will always return a string. Always return a string. Always returns a string. So the next example you see is a little bit more complex. We use the same input function. We pass it a string for the prompt the user will see when the program runs. But then we take the return value from that input function, which of course is a string, and we try to cast it to an int, to an integer, or a whole number. Hopefully the user has typed something that looks like an integer or the program will actually crash. You could test that out yourself. Then the next two lines are simply output statements that print. And so in this case, we're just going to print hello. And notice the comma, a separator between the string hello and the variable name. This comma separator will always insert a space in between the two elements. So any place where you put a comma in your output list, you'll get a space. The next statement is another print statement. This time we print a string, a space, the value in the age variable, another space, and then finally a string. Now the area that you see here at the top is the code editor where I can input my code. And the area you see here at the bottom called the shell is where the code will actually be executed. You can resize the shell area. You can even hide the shell area. Unfortunately, when you hit run, it doesn't redisplay it. So you'd have to go to the view menu and make sure you have the shell visible so you can actually see the output of your program. Let's go ahead and run this program. So I'll go ahead and click the run button up here in the toolbar. And again, as I indicated, it will run down in the shell window, so I'll go ahead and type in a name. And it prompts for age. And then it prints out the output as we expected. Notice again, the spaces are showing up where those commas are. Whoops, not there. The comma is right here in front of age. And then there's a comma right here in front of years old. Of course, in the strings up here, you'll notice that indeed I had a space already. So that's where that space comes from. Also notice on the prompts here for the inputs, I put a space after the question mark inside the string there. That's why there's a space right here after the question mark, because it's actually part of the output string for the prompt. Okay, let's just stop with that.